You will always have two types of knowledge. The first knowledge is called aparavidya. The second knowledge is called paravidya. The aparavidya is what we study for a job. We study in the day-to-day life how to live. It could be even how to meditate also comes there only. Anything where there is a doing involved, anything, asana, pranayama, meditation, everything, anything where there is a doing involved, it can be taught. Very simple. It can be taught because there is a doing involved. It could be making a vegetable garden. It could be how to open an umbrella. You can go to internet. You had many, many, many things. How to release the cycle from its stand. Somebody would have written a blog on that also. You think of anything, people would have written something, correct? All this is aparavidya, which is helping us to live in the external world and which will be changing. Because today, if you release a book on how to learn typewriting, maybe even the printing press will not print that book. You have to do self-publishing. You got it. So this aparavidya domain will keep changing. Like for example, today we are wearing this dress. 100 years back, this dress was nowhere to be seen. 10 years back, I don't know whether people will wear dress the way people are there today. You understand? So this knowledge of things which are outside will always change. Even medicine. That is why in Ayurveda, the great Charaka has mentioned, the science of Ayurveda will continue to evolve. It is not a stagnant subject because it is study of things, herbs, everything around. But there is one vidya which there is no change, which is called the paravidya. What is that? The supreme knowledge by knowing which everything else is known. In our great texts, it is mentioned as Brahman, and we keep using the word Paramatma, Paramatma, things like that, supreme soul, things like that. So the entire idea of Indian tradition is give us both, and like a child, after it plays whatever toys it needs, it comes back to the mother, right? Then the mother will say, now you are tired, have this juice or something, do the homework. Correct? Like that, we are allowed a free ground to play with life the way we want. But the day you decide what is going on, let me understand what really life is. Who am I? Where I am going? From where did I come from? What should I do to know who I exactly am? I really know I am not this. I am something else. Correct? So when that question comes very sincerely, then such a person approaches the teacher. That teacher is called a guru.